Hello, everyone. I'm Wendy Dietzler, Director of Events and Education for Trade Press Media Group, and I want to thank you all for joining today's webcast. The rapid growth of IoT extends to fire and life safety with Connected Safety Plus. Our presenter today is Ben Saunders, Global Connected Offerings Leader for Edwards Commercial Fire. Prior to his role at Edwards, Ben was Global Senior Product Manager at LexisNexis Risk Solutions, with a background in developing training solutions for the U.S. Department of Defense at General Dynamics. Ben brings a truly diverse skill set to his role. He also holds an MBA from the University of Florida and a Master of Science degree in Computer Science from Florida Atlantic University. Ben's going to be joined by some additional subject matter experts later to help with the Q&A portion of today's event. He'll introduce them in a little bit. In the meantime, let's talk about today's learning objectives. We've got four. First is learn how to enhance asset management and reduce total cost of ownership. Review how to increase accessibility with remote and system diagnostics. Discuss enhanced sustainability objectives and ESG goals. And finally, learn how to improve end-to-end fire system cybersecurity with cloud-based technologies. So we're just about to get today's event underway. Just a couple more housekeeping details. We really do encourage audience questions throughout the webcast. So if you've got one that you'd like to ask, please navigate to the Q&A button at the bottom of your screen, type in your questions at any time, and during Q&A, we'll get to as many as time permits. After today's webcast, you're going to receive via email a PDF copy of today's presentation slides and a link to a brief online assessment. When you successfully complete that four-question assessment, you'll receive a CEU certificate as well. Finally, today's webcast will be archived at facilitiesnet.com/webcasts. I'm all done. So Ben, I'm going to hand it over to you.
Great. Thanks, Wendy. Good afternoon. Good morning, everybody. Very excited to be with you today to talk about IoT and the rapid growth and how it affects our life safety industry. So the first thing I wanted to talk about was not only myself, but the two subject matter experts that are going to be joining me at the Q&A at the conclusion of today's presentation. So we'll have Wally Ortiz, who's our senior product manager, focused on our fire panels and fire systems. And we'll also have Ron Crotty, who's going to be joining, who's our digital subject matter expert as well. So let's jump in and let's get started. So let's start from a high level. What does the IoT industry look like today, and how does this impact our life safety industry? So IoT, or Internet of Things market in smart commercial buildings, grew to $53.5 billion in 2022. And this is expected to further grow at a CAGR, an annual at 10.33% to $96.5 billion by 2028. So the number of IoT connected devices installed in commercial smart buildings is expected to grow over 1.5 billion all the way to 3.25 billion by 2028. So some of the main drivers for this IoT adoption are better accountability when dealing with fire safety. Some of the main challenges include cybersecurity, complexity, fragmentation. Some of those other drivers are sustainability, energy efficiency, and performance improvement. So we'll talk a little bit about how this affects our industry and how this can affect your business as well as your end users. So one story I wanted to kind of discuss a little bit to give you an idea, maybe in your everyday life, many of you likely have apps on your phones that are monitoring, let's say, something back at your house. Let's say it's your air conditioner thermostat. So I actually had a personal experience a couple of years ago where I was on vacation, and I live in Florida where it gets very hot in summer. And what happened was my air conditioner froze up. I was overworking in July. And when I came back from my vacation, my air conditioner had not been working for about 10 days and quite a bit of property damage at my house. So the first thing I did was go out and get a connected thermostat so that I could monitor that through my phone when I'm away from the house or when I'm out of the country or on travel. And I can actually receive notifications if there's any kind of issue with the thermostat, if it's not working, if my air conditioner goes down. So I wanted to give that example, that real world experience that I had as a starting point for our journey with Connected Safety Plus, with our Edwards Fire Systems, with our life safety industry. So moving on from there, talk a little bit more about what's driving these cloud powered solutions. So things like managing your assets. So being able to monitor and manage assets, monitoring your fire system, monitoring detectors, specific devices, how they're performing without having to go onto a site. Sustainability. So if we can do some of those activities remotely, we can reduce the number of truck rolls and the number of on-site visits that are required. And that can start to play into some of those ESG goals that many of you are likely working on today. For our end users and for our building occupants, if we can do things like prevent false alarms, we can reduce those disruptions for the occupants and make those experiences seamless and less disruptions. And we can also improve the facilities management by providing life cycle maintenance predictability as well. And then in terms of security, so this is obviously something that is of high importance when we talk about connecting our fire systems to external networks and to the cloud. So this is something that's very important and something that we'll talk a little bit more about in detail throughout the presentation. So the graphic here kind of shows you what we'll be talking about from a high level today. So basically we're taking our Edwards flagship EST4 fire alarm system, and we're securely connecting that to our cloud-based platform so that we can take the data and unlock all of that intelligence that lives in the fire panel today that typically you would have to be on site to access. We're taking all of that intelligence, all of that data, putting it in our cloud, applying analytics, AI, machine learning, and then serving that back up to our customers and our end users through value-added services, through a web application and a mobile application. So with that, I'd like to introduce you all to Edwards Connected Safety Plus. So this is our digital platform and suite of connected solutions. So again, Edwards Connected Safety Plus gathers the performance data of the fire system from those different elements within, from detectors, from pole stations, from networked panels, from all the different equipment and sensors. And then we're able to provide that back to our users through an easy to use, easy to understand application, which we'll get into an actual demonstration of that here in a bit. So we're able to visualize all of that data. So not only are we able to access the data remotely without having to be on site, we're also going to visualize that data, making it easier to understand and pull insights from that data. We'll also be able to, through those visualizations and through those insights, start to do things like predictive maintenance, where we can see if we can take the percent dirty of a detector across a site, and we can see what the acceleration of that percentage of dirtiness is over time, we can actually start to predict when that detector will reach a threshold where that percent dirty will actually potentially cause a trouble in the fire alarm system or potentially even a false alarm. So these are the types of insights that we'll start to use this application for. And we're really just getting started with this. So our goal is to get this out there to the customers, start to get feedback and start to learn and work with our customers and with our end users on how this solution, how this platform, and how this application can provide more insights and more value throughout our customer base. So we've been, over the past few months, we've been working with some select customers on this, and we've been gathering voice of customer, identifying pain points, and more recently, we've actually been doing things like field trials and pilots of the solution. So some of the things that we heard throughout that process is just the ability to be able to dial in remotely into the fire system and gain access to see what a potential problem is without having to travel all the way to the site is a major value. A lot of times, some of those basic data elements are available from a central station dealer app. So you might get some kind of indication that there's some sort of trouble or supervisory, but really you don't have the level of data that you need to make a decision before you make a trip to the site. So you might not necessarily know what kind of device type is having the trouble. Through our solution, we're going to be providing much higher level fidelity data so that you can actually get the full picture of what's going on site before you leave the office, ensuring that you have the right equipment and also that you're sending the right technician to respond to any issues that are going on site. So again, this is a digitally enabled, what we call SaaS or software as a service lifecycle solution for an enhanced connected fire system experience. This is not a replacement for things like a central monitoring station, which is monitoring actual emergency events. This is more for the service, maintenance, test, and inspect of the fire system. So the services are really focused on efficiencies in those areas and reducing or eliminating all of those manual paper-based processes and really making it easier for our customers and our end users to interact with Edwards products. So some of the things that we'll get into in the demonstration include a proactive view of system issues, not only at one site, but across your entire portfolio. Real-time reports and analytics for all of your connected assets. So today, typically, when a technician arrives on site, the first thing that they might do is go to the panel and pull some reports to see what is the latest status, what's the health of the fire system. Now that same technician will be able to pull those reports from their mobile application on their phone or through their web browser before they leave the office. Predictive maintenance analytics. So those are the things that I talked about earlier with the percent dirty of the detectors. So we can start to predict when that detector might reach a threshold that'll cause an issue, meaning that we can take preventative actions rather than reacting to a false alarm or to a trouble event. We can also do things like predict when a device is approaching end of life per compliance. So we'll see that in the demonstration as well. We actually visualize that data so that we can give you 6, 3, and 1 month awareness and notifications that these devices need to be replaced, specifically CO devices, in order for the site to remain in compliance. Those insights can be used by customers to interact with their end users to show the information that you need to prepare for this in your annual budget. So you're kind of giving those advanced insights into prepping for that financially as well. We also have, through our mobile application, the ability to conduct a connected inspection, sometimes referred to as a walk test. So typically today, you might have a couple of technicians on site when you're conducting an annual inspection of the system. One person might be at the panel, they're communicating via radio or via phone back and forth, and then you have a second technician who's walking the site and initiating devices to ensure that they're functioning as expected. Through our Connected Safety Plus solution, that same technician that is walking the site is actually able to see all of those events come right into their mobile application, confirming that the devices are working as expected, the events are making it to the fire panel and actually passing from the fire panel into our cloud and back to that user's mobile application on their phone. We'll also be able to check off whether that device passed or failed the inspection. And if it did fail, they can include notes that can be used post-inspection for deficiency reporting, and that can be communicated back to the end user So if there's any return work that needs to be performed in order to get the site in full compliance, all of that is digitally captured in the application so that you don't have to go through all of those manual paper-based workflows that I mentioned earlier. So in terms of specific features, these are some of our differentiated features. So the Manager Plus is our single dashboard. So this is the dashboard where you can view all of your sites in one place. You can quickly determine which sites need your attention if you've got a specific site that's been activated in a queue. And then you can drill down from that portfolio level into a specific site level. And then you can further drill down into device level. So you can really troubleshoot the issue remotely before you leave the office. Again, and then that just gives you that advanced preparation and notice of what's taking place on site before you roll your truck. Floor Plan Plus. So this actually enables a user to import the floor plan of the site. So if you have your CAD file, we allow you to import that into ConnectedSafety Plus. And then what we do is we take that file, we also import the system configuration of the Edwards EST4. And then we make a match between the devices on the floor plan and the devices in the system configuration. And we do something we call auto placement. So this means that you don't have to manually place all those devices in our tool. And then once we've made that association, we can dynamically update the state of those devices within ConnectedSafety Plus. So if you have a device that's activated in a different queue type, we can show you that. And then during that connected inspection, we can actually show you visually which devices have been tested and which have passed, which have failed the inspection. We also have an interesting additional service here, which we call our Tech Support Plus. With Tech Support Plus, this allows our Edwards Tech Support team to view your connected site system during any support calls. So if you have a technician who's out in the field, they're having a particular issue with the EST4 system, they call into our tech support. If that EST4 system is ConnectedSafety Plus enabled, our tech support can actually pull up that site and that system and help troubleshoot the technician who is on site. And then by doing that, we can accelerate the resolution of that issue, reduce on-site time, and then minimize any disruptions to the site as well. So just to kind of summarize some of the value that ConnectedSafety Plus is offering both to our strategic partners, which is our direct customers, as well as to facility managers and end users. So troubleshooting those issues remotely, reducing those non-billable truck rolls. So that's a benefit both to the strategic partner and to the end user that helps to minimize some of that on-site disruption to occupants. Ability to predict and potentially prevent false alarms. So being able to see the percent dirty of those detectors and being able to take preventative action rather than responding and reacting when you have a false alarm or when the system goes into trouble. Increasing those first-time fix rates. Again, having that insight, bringing the right equipment that you need, having the right people responding, the right technicians with the right skill set. Something that we didn't talk about yet is as the different events are coming in from the fire system, within our ConnectedSafety Plus application, you can configure how you would like to receive notifications of those different events. So you can receive which events you would like to receive notifications for, and you can also customize how you would like to receive them. So if you'd like to receive them by email, push notification, text, all of that's at your fingertips, and we'll look a little bit at that in the demonstration as well. And then also that Manager Plus, that scalable portfolio. So as your business grows, as your connected installation base grows, the ability to view all of that from a single dashboard, and then the ability to drill deeper and deeper into the data to get additional insights. And then that Floor Plan Plus, the ability to visualize where the devices are So that plays into what we call our guided inspection. So with the guided inspection, a lot of times today, and a lot of the feedback that we got from our customers is that when they're conducting an inspection, sometimes it's hard to find the actual device that they're trying to inspect or test. So once you've incorporated your floor plan and you leverage our floor plan plus feature along with inspection plus, we can actually guide you from device to device visually on the floor plan. And then that will also help reduce that per device inspection time, which means you can take on additional inspections over time. And then switching from the value of the strategic partner over to the facility manager and end user, just the ability to have that insight, that visualization, that remote monitoring of the system, and then having the notifications going to your strategic partner or whoever it is that is responsible for the service and the maintenance of your system, we can increase that system uptime. Just having more visibility, taking better care of it, so to speak, is going to increase that system uptime, and it's going to protect your investment as well. Also, cloud access to compliance reports. So one thing that we did hear both from our strategic partners and from our end users is it would be really nice to have secure access to my annual compliance report. So whenever you're getting called on for that compliance report, typically a facility manager or an end user might contact the service partner, strategic partner, and say, hey, I need a copy of my annual compliance report, which takes time away from both parties. With ConnectedSafety Plus, they'll have their own secure access and they can access those compliance reports whenever they need to. They also have the ability to access all the system status. So they can see the events, they can see the health and the status of their investment of their system as well. They can also configure the notifications the same way as the strategic partner. So depending on the relationship between the strategic partner and the end user, that whole relationship and the way that that ConnectedSafety Plus communicates to both parties can be customized. Also, some of those predictive insights about lifecycle costs and forecasting, those are a major benefit to a facility manager, to an end user as well. Again, because that helps to incorporate that into your annual or quarterly budgets. And then, of course, if we can do things like prevent or reduce false alarms through ConnectedSafety Plus, through some of those insights, obviously that will reduce any disruptions to building occupants. And then Tech Support Plus, that just gives us the ability to provide a higher level of tech support, having that connected view of the system, of the site, and then accelerating those in-field issues, reducing that on-site time, and then of course, reducing overall disruptions. Cybersecurity. So I wanted to focus a little bit on this. So this is something that with all of our products, not just our connected products, but Edwards in general, we spend a lot of time and a lot of focus on cybersecurity. We know how important this is to our customers and how important it is to ourselves as well for the integrity of our products. So with ConnectedSafety Plus, now that we're taking data, we're connecting these life safety systems, which are protecting property and of course lives. We want to ensure that there's no way to hack into this or disable this, or that our system is going to interfere with any of those life safety capabilities. So we've spent a lot of time with what we call our three core missions from a cybersecurity perspective. We have a secure product development process that we follow that goes through a number of iterations through approvals and testing. We have a product security operations group that oversees all of that and helps guide us through that process. And then we also do things like cybersecurity innovation. So we're constantly following trends. What's the latest technology? What's the latest innovation? How do we make our cybersecurity better? And then we also partner with some of our cloud providers like AWS. So we also incorporate their existing cybersecurity solutions. So one of the things in the future, as cybersecurity becomes more and more important, as we connect more of our systems to the cloud, you'll start to see more and more of this coming from compliance, from NFPA. So this will eventually start to become part of your annual inspection. We'll be doing cybersecurity audits and penetration tests of your system. So we fully plan to support that with ConnectedSafety Plus, and we plan to offer solutions to help guide you through that process as well. Okay. So with that, I am going to stop sharing just for a moment, and then we'll transition over to a live demonstration of the application. Okay. So this is our ConnectedSafety Plus application. So this is our web version of the solution. And this is a demonstration version of this. This is something that we actually just recently used in Las Vegas at the NFPA conference back in June. So we actually set this up to leverage some of the casinos on the Las Vegas Strip. So some of these site names might be familiar to you. So this is really that portfolio view of where you can see all your connected sites, if those sites are activated in any specific queues, if you have something activated in an alarm, supervisor, or trouble. You can also see visually where your sites are located. So again, in these particular sites, we've got a number that we've associated on the Las Vegas Strip. And then from here, you can actually dive deeper into the details of each specific site to figure out what's going on, what's causing this trouble, what's the device that's causing this, what's the device history, and what's the action that I can take to resolve this issue as quick as possible. We also, at this level, provide some information about different active incidents. So this will help you to determine, do you have specific sites that are particularly problematic? Maybe there's something going on with that site. Maybe there's something environmental. And in a minute, we'll start to see how we can visualize that data to determine if there's any patterns in events for a specific site. So drilling down from this portfolio level, and this is really meant to give you those quick insights, you know, which site do I need to focus on? So going from that portfolio level, let's dive into a specific site. So this particular site, we're calling it the NFPA conference hall. So this was at the Mandalay Bay, which is where the NFPA conference was hosted this year. So this particular site has 960 devices in the device inventory, three of which are currently activated in the trouble queue. So we're able to give you more information about that particular site. So we can see which devices have the most incidents. So again, that plays into, are there specific devices that are problematic that need to be serviced or potentially replaced? You can also see a breakdown of your device inventory by device type. We also have what we call our events heat map. I'm actually gonna bring up a different site that has a little bit more data. This is what I was referring to earlier when you talk about seasonality. So let's say that every September you have a specific site that is particularly problematic, the detectors are activating, and you know, it's something environmental. Let's say there's humidity near the detector that time of year, and it's causing a truck roll, which is causing a disruption to the end user, and it's also causing the strategic partner an unscheduled truck roll. So if you're able to visualize that and start to identify the patterns in those events, you can actually take preventative measures so that you can prevent that from happening the following year. Similarly, this is where you can see the percent dirty of the detectors. So this particular site, we've got seven detectors that are less than 50%. We've got two that are between 50 and 59. We've got three between 60 and 69. And then I've got just one that's kind of approaching that 80% threshold, which is when you're really starting to get into an area where you might run into trouble or potentially even a false alarm. So this is these are some of the insights and some of the data visualization that it just makes it easier to interpret the data coming out of the fire system without having to read line by line the detailed data. Another similar insight that we can provide is that I spoke about earlier. For CO devices, we can show you the days remaining before those devices go out of compliance. So if you have a device that, let's say, has to be replaced per code every 7 years, because we have connection to the full configuration and device inventory, we know when that device was installed, and we know when that device needs to be replaced in order for the site and the system to remain in compliance. And we can show you that visually, and that information can be used between the strategic partner and with the end user to plan efficiently for replacement of those devices as well, including budgetary needs. We can also show you what type of users are assigned to the site. So within ConnectedSafety Plus, we have an administrator role. We have a site manager role, which is typically somebody that would be on site, a facility manager, somebody that the strategic partner, the service provider is typically interacting with, who's on site. Then we have a technician. So these are typically the boots on the ground, so to speak. So they're responding to service calls. They're doing the inspections. So each one of these role types has different level of access within the tool. So going from there, from that high level of data visualization, let's take a deeper dive into the data that's providing all of that data, or into the information that's providing all that data for the visualization. So from this screen, this is our FACU. So these are connected fire alarm control unit systems. So this particular one, obviously we have an EST4. We can see that it's connected. It's up and running, so to speak. Can also look at our complete device inventory. So these are all of the devices within this 960. And we can filter this view by specific device type. We can also customize the view. There's certain columns that you're particularly interested in, let's say the system address, and you don't really care about some of the other ones. You can set this up however you see fit. So let's go ahead and take a closer look at one of these devices. So I'm just gonna pull up a pull station in this particular scenario. So when you pull this up, you're actually gonna get our image of that actual device. And then you'll also see if you've leveraged our floor plan plus feature and you've added your floor plan, you'll actually be able to see specifically where this device is located on the floor plan. So this will help with if you are responding to a service call or also when you're conducting that connected inspection, you can see exactly where that device is located. And then we can provide you with the system address, device type, obviously the model, serial number, all this information, and depending on the device type, some of these fields will be populated, some won't. So that just kind of gives you an idea of the level of detail that we can provide that you're not going to be able to get from a CMS dealer app. Similar to the devices, we can also see all the events that are coming. So these are all your troubles, all of your alarms, all of your supervisory events that are coming in. And what we've actually done, because one thing that we heard a lot from our customers was that I don't necessarily need a notification for every single event that comes in. So what we did was we came up with an intelligent way to group the events into what we call incidents. And the incidents are grouped together by queue type. So if you have a particular site and you have a detector that activates in a trouble state, that'll create an incident. And then if another detector goes into that same queue, it'll append to that incident. That incident will remain active until all devices have been restored. And instead of sending you every single event, what we'll do is we'll send you a 15-minute update on the status of that incident. We'll take a little bit closer look at what those incidents look like. So this particular incident, you've got, three devices affected. You can actually assign an owner. Once you assign an owner, that person becomes responsible for the resolution of that incident. You can see this is the queue type is trouble, when it was created, when it was last changed. You can see which devices are involved in this incident. And then you can also see the events that are coming in related to that incident. We also have what we call an activity log. So this activity log will actually show you all of the activity related to that specific incident. And you can also use this kind of as a chat feature between a service provider, a strategic partner, and somebody who's on site. So if you've got somebody who's on site and you haven't arrived yet, and you want to not only communicate, but record that communication in this incident report, you can go ahead and do that. So you can say, Ron is the detector still activating. Yeah, just as an example, you can put this in here and then that'll append to this activity log. And then when the incident's closed, you'll have a full record of everything that took place related to that incident. So going back, going also to our what we call our Inspection Plus. So what this is, there's two components to the Inspection Plus. You have the mobile application, which we talked about earlier, which is what the technician who's on site in the field is going to use while they're doing their actual walk test or guided inspection. That data can be monitored back at the office by a supervisor. So if you've got a number of technicians that are out in the field and you want to monitor the progress of those inspections, see if they're on schedule, see if they are performing as expected, you can actually come to the screen and see all of the different inspections that are taking place. And what we do is we're able to show you the progress, and that's based on the number of devices that are to be inspected. So if you have 50 devices and 10 of them have been inspected, we can show you the percent. So you can kind of get an idea of how your team is performing that day with those inspections. So if we go from there, and we also have a cybersecurity feature, which actually just demonstrated itself. So we also have a timeout period where if you have an inactivity for a specific login of the system, we actually have that so that it auto logs out so that somebody can't just walk by and start to use the application without authorization. So if we go back to our NFPA conference hall, the last thing I wanted to show you before we get into our Q&A is our reports feature. So these are reports that today a technician would have to travel on site, go to the panel and pull these reports. Now we're actually giving you the ability to pull these reports through your mobile application or through your web application. So you could come in here, you say click on report, you select which FACU, if there's any report subtype, and then you can give it a name, test report 2. And then you create the report, and then that'll kick off a process. It'll start to pull the actual fire system to pull that report. And then once you pull the report, once it's complete, what you can do is you can get a PDF version of that pull report. We can also put it into a CSV file. You can share that report with other users. You can delete the report. So we're trying to give you as many options and features as possible on how you might use that. So in addition to the standard panel reports, and one other thing I wanted to show you is this update feature. So what this does is this actually gives you control over how often this particular screen synchronizes with the data that's coming in from the fire system. So we can go down to a 10-second granularity, or we can put it at 2 hours. It really depends on how often you want that data to refresh. So I'm going to put it on 2 hours right now just for the sake of the demonstration so it's not constantly refreshing. But I also wanted to show you, in addition to the panel reports, we can also create an NFPA compliance report. So once you finish your inspection, you want to fill out the required NFPA compliance report. And what we do is we give you the ability to do that digitally. So we also try to pre-fill as much data as we can. So if we have premises name, address, things like that, we can pre-fill that. And over time, as the solution evolves, we'll pre-fill more and more of this data based on the inspection that we've conducted. And that'll reduce some of that manual data entry, thereby reducing your overall inspection time over time. But basically, we give you the ability to digitally fill this out. And then also what we do at the end is we give you the ability to, and just go ahead and create a new one. So we can add a branded cover page. So if you want to add a little bit more sort of flair to your report, you can include a branded cover page. I will say no for now, but this kind of gives you an idea of what that NFPA compliance template that I'm sure many of you are very familiar with. You pre-filled some of that data. You can fill out the rest manually. And then what we'll do is we give you the ability to add additional supporting material. So that could include some of those panel reports that we talked about, and also include, and this is where the real value of the connected inspection comes into play. We can attach and append the results of that connected inspection, meaning all of those events that came into your application during that inspection, those can be appended to the compliance report to show that you actually tested all the devices that you're claiming that you tested. So now you have digital proof coming from the fire system that you actually tested each device. So in this one, we'll just give it another test report to figure out which inspection that you conducted. So you associate the inspection that you did with the report. And then this is where you can add additional panel reports if you would like to include that as well. And then the specific report. So what you would do then is go next. And then the other thing that we do, if let's say you have additional material that you want to include as your package that you're going to submit to the AHJ and to your end user. Let's say you have another file type or some supporting material that you have on your local desktop. Give you the ability to package that up as well. So you can browse your local desktop. You can add any additional files. And now you've got this comprehensive package that shows that you truly conducted this inspection backed by digital proof. We'll go ahead and say next. And then this will generate that full compliance report. It'll append all that additional data. And then what you can do is once that's complete, you can make it, once this strategic partner is ready to publish that, so to speak, for their end user, they can do that in the application. And then from that point on, the end user facility manager will have that secure cloud access to that compliance report. And then they can also provide that to the HJ as well. I think we have maybe just about 5 minutes before we get into the Q&A. So I wanted to talk a little bit more about some of the customization since we do have a little bit more time. So one thing I wanted to show you is at a global level, you have the ability to set up the notifications like I was mentioning earlier. So what this means is for the different notification types, queues, incidents, user management, licensing, general announcements, you can actually set this up at a global level for all your connected sites. So you can determine what notifications each one of these role types receives. So let's say you don't want the site manager, the facility manager, to receive all of these notifications. You can set them up to only receive alarm or supervisory or trouble. Similarly to technicians, if you want a technician assigned to the site, maybe they're only interested in receiving trouble or supervisory events. This is the functionality in the area within the application where you can fully customize that however you see fit. Now, once you save this, this is automatically by default going to be inherited by all your sites. Some sites might require different functionality. So now I want to show you how you can actually disable that global setting so that you can do a little bit more customization at the site level. And that's basically accomplished through this global preferences checkbox. So if this global preferences checkbox is enabled, this will automatically pull in those settings that we just looked at the global level. Now, if you wanted to come in here and customize this at the site level, of course, you could turn this off, disable this. And then you can really go, you know, notification type by notification and really customize this however you see fit. The other thing I want to show you is the floor plan. So this is where we basically import the 4CU, which is our configuration of the fire system. So if you're familiar with the EST4, this will look familiar. This is the full configuration of the system. So we pull this in from the EST4 and we're constantly synchronizing this to ensure that what we have in the cloud is matching what the actual fire system configuration is. So we're constantly pulling this in. And then on the left side, what this is our digital twin of that configuration. So what we've done here is we've imported the floor plan, the DWG file, and we can actually see where these devices are located from this configuration. And once we match what's in this file with what's in our configuration, we're able to do some of those dynamic updates and we're able to do some of that guided inspection that we talked about earlier. Another site administration feature is that you may have a number of technicians within your organization that are responsible for specific sites. So through ConnectedSafety Plus, those users will only receive notifications and will only have access to data that an administrator has assigned them to. So if they're not assigned to that site, they won't have access to the data and they won't be able to see any of the information. In addition to the global settings and the way that you're able, an administrator is able to set up which role type receives which type of notifications, a specific individual user can also configure how they receive the notification. So if you want to receive it through the app, through mobile, desktop, email, or all, as an individual user, you can come in here and customize that. You can also toggle off your notifications and on. So let's say you're going on vacation, or let's say there's a particular time of day that you want to receive or not receive notifications. You can actually come in here and customize that however you see fit. So we've really spent a lot of time on making this easy as possible to understand, visually appealing. We tried to not over-engineer this because really the goal for us is to make all of those jobs to be done related to Edwards products easier, freeing up time to focus on some of those higher profitability jobs and opportunities, and also on the end user side to reduce those disruptions and really to protect your investment, protect property, and of course to protect life safety as well. So we spent a lot of our time on that, and hopefully that came through in the demonstration. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and stop the demonstration. I'm going to stop sharing. And we're going to transition over into our Q&A session with our subject matter experts that we talked about earlier. All right. So I think we've got a number of questions that I think the team has likely been answering some of them. So let's go ahead and look at some of these questions, and then we'll answer as many as we can, and any that we can't, we will have access and the ability to respond to this after the webinar. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at this. So one of them, it looks like there's a question about the formats of the compliance reports. So the one that we looked at was obviously the NFPA, and this question may have popped up before I got to that. We will be looking to expand those templates. We do understand that specific AHJs have requirements and needs for, not just the sort of NFPA standard one, but there's ones that are more specific. We also know that there's ones that are required for hospitals, like the Joint Commission report and things like that. So with our initial launch, we will have the NFPA one that I demonstrated, but we do have a prioritized list of reports and templates that we'll be adding over time. So let's see, what else do we have? Okay, another good question is, does this system work with other manufacturers' fire alarm system? So This particular instance of Connected Safety Plus is focused on our flagship product, which is our Edwards EST4 system. We do have a roadmap of integrating all of our Edwards products. And of course, we understand that our customers do not only service Edwards products. So we also have a path to support some of those third-party systems as well. It'll probably be more of like a light version because of course, some of the data transmission can be proprietary and you can't necessarily get all of the data from other products, but absolutely. We want to support our customers as best as possible. And we understand that this solution needs to support their full business. So that is something that we absolutely is part of our longer term plan. Okay, so there's another question about what is the lag time to the overall system? Can it be connected to a BMS system like Dell Tech? So currently, we do not have necessarily any specific functionality that's set up to do BACnet or Modbus from Connected Safety Plus. We do have that existing functionality from the EST4. And Wally, you might want to respond to that. Maybe that's one that you can take in terms of how the EST4 today is able to connect into a BMS.
Yeah, so you're right. So if there is a need to connect directly onto the panel to a third-party building management system, yes, we do support BACnet, BACnet IP, Modbus, LawnWorks, some of the more common type of protocols used in the industry. So those can be connected and communicating directly onto EST4. We do have what we refer to as a field server bridge, which is a gateway that translates the data coming from EST4 into one of those protocols that I just mentioned. So it can communicate to any third party building management system on the other side of the fire panel.
Yeah. Thanks, Waller. Hopefully that responded to the question, answered the question. I had another one. So this is another one similar. So can CS Plus be used with older Edwards EST3X and IO systems? So I think if we address that, that is part of the plan. We will be looking at, you know, which panels in our install base to connect. And we want your feedback on that as well. So what are the ones that are most important to you? What would you like to see us support next? Is it one of our legacy panels? Is it the third party panel that we talked about earlier? So that's something that we'll be looking to collect customer feedback, but absolutely in terms of overall plan, the plan is to support and connect to as many systems as possible. So another question related to the connected inspection reports, can these be used to satisfy local fire marshal inspection report requests? Absolutely. Again, because we are using that NFPA template, that will satisfy that. And with some of the additional things that we're going to be providing, we're actually going to be providing more data than typical because we do have the data to back up that the devices have actually have been tested and have been inspected. We have that digital proof. There's another question about the 4F wall, which we didn't talk a lot about today. So the 4F wall is the device. It's an IP-based connection. So the 4F wall is an existing Edwards product, which basically separates the EST4 system from the outside world. Wally, you're probably best suited to maybe respond and explain the 4F wall as well, if you don't mind.
Yeah, so the way that I think about that is the proxy firewall that separates, just like you've indicated, the fire system from the outside world. So when we were developing EST4, we understood and we recognized that nowadays customers expect systems like EST4 to be connected to the outside world because there are many benefits that you mentioned, right, that come along with that. Having information ahead of the dispatch of a service technician to a site and knowing what is wrong, what equipment to take, it creates a lot of efficiencies in terms of serviceability to a system. So when that was being developed, we created this F wall, and this is the mechanism that again, protects the fire system from outside cyber threats. So if it happens to, and that in conjunction with a commercial firewall would be what we recommend in terms of protecting the fire system. But anytime one of these systems needs to be connected to the outside world, whether it's CS Plus or any other type of device that might connect to an app world like central monitoring station, for example, it will always be done through this, as this is where the cyber protection for the system resides on. And this is where CS Plus also connects onto the fire system. And not only CS Plus, but there are many services or many concurrent connections that can be connected through a single app wall on EST4. So hopefully that answers the question, but if there is a follow-up or something else that needs to be clarified, by all means, submit another question and we'll add more wherever necessary.
Yeah, thanks, Wally. Another question. So this is a, looks like a standards or compliance related question. So I touched on it a little bit earlier, but much of our industry is obviously highly regulated. When it comes to IoT solutions, really what we're doing is monitoring the system and the state. We're not changing, we're not doing any command and control remotely or anything like that as of today. What I will say is we're already starting to see some updates from NFPA. So in the latest version, 2022, you're starting to see some clarity on what you can and can't do. If you can confirm and validate that, let's say a technician is on site, and they are conducting an inspection, we're already starting to see some clarity that we can actually put in our application the ability to do some basic panel commands while in test mode. So again, that'll just make it easier to conduct an inspection while on site. It'll prevent the technician from having to go back and forth to the panel. So we are starting to see that. And I think in terms of longevity, the longer that systems are connected, the more data that we can show, and the more that we can show that these solutions are safe, we'll start to see that really evolve and really start to transform the industry as a whole, not just on the IoT side, but on the regulated side as well. So hopefully that answered that question. Got just a couple more minutes. Another one I see is, will CS Plus integrate with third-party applications? The answer there would be yes. So we're not going to, there are certain things that, and certain tools that we know a lot of our customers are using today. So that could be things like dispatch tools, scheduling, things like that. Those are the areas that are not necessarily our expertise. There's a lot of solutions already out there today. And with those types of solutions, we'll really be looking at what is the best application, third-party application for us to integrate with and partner with. And a lot of that will come from our customer base. So we'll be reaching out to customers to determine what's the preferred dispatch or scheduling tool as an example. And then we'll look to do a third-party integration with those tools. Similarly, if there's solutions out there that make it easier to submit your compliance reports to HJ, and I know there's a number of them out there, we'll be looking to do those types of integrations as well. We really want to make this, again, we want to make all of those jobs to be done with our products easier, more efficient. We want to make it so that there's not many apps that you have to log into. So our goal is really single point of entry with this solution. One app, we understand that there are going to be certain things that we can't do everything in the app. And that's where those third-party integrations come into play. All right, I think we are right at time. There are a couple more questions there, and we will go ahead and address those offline. But I wanted to thank everybody for their time today. Hopefully this was informative. Hopefully you're as excited as we are, and please reach out to us for any additional questions or one-on-one demos or anything else that we can provide to you. So back to you, Wendy. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks so much, Ben, for an excellent presentation and a demo. Wally, Ron, thank you as well for that expertise in the Q&A. And as you heard Ben mention, there will be some opportunities for this team to follow up on some of those questions offline. So sit tight on those. In the meantime, you will be receiving an email shortly with a PDF version of the slides that Ben presented. You will also receive that link to a CEU assessment that gives you credit for attending today's educational session. And finally, this entire archive will be posted within about 48 hours at facilitiesnet.com/webcasts. So you'll be able to go back and view all of the information that was shared as well. So again, thank you everybody for your participation. And thank you again, Ben, Wally, Ron, and Edwards for an excellent informative session today. With that, I'll conclude today's webinar.